Hello friends, welcome to another episode by Engineering Today, and we're back again with some interesting updates for you. We'll first take a look at the Starbase video shared by SpaceX on Twitter following SpaceX's upcoming Crew 3 mission, and wrap up with Airbus Ventures' investment in iSpace. Let's get started with SpaceX sharing a video on the development of Starbase with spectacular views of Starship. While preparations are going on for the upcoming Orbital Flight Test (OFT) of Starship, SpaceX teams have recently shared a video on Starbase development on the 24th of October on their official Twitter page. SpaceX teams tagged the video as Gateway to Mars. This post came nearly a day after Elon Musk shared a view of Starship and Super Heavy with the moon in the back on his Twitter page and had written, "Starbase under construction." Report says that the shared video has a time span of about 1 minute and 31 seconds. It showed spectacular views of the Starbase factories, making of Starbase nose cones, glimpses of the stacked steel rings, numerous sea-level and vacuum-optimized Raptor engines inside the factory shades. The video also showed the transportation of the Starship prototype to the launch pad, then launch of the vehicle, several maneuvers and complex flips high in the air, and also safe landing of the ship. The last part of the video showed the epic stacking of the Ship 20 with the booster BN-4 in the orbital launch site, making it the largest spacecraft ever stacked. Which Starship prototype was shown in the video is not mentioned by SpaceX, but the report says that the fully successful landing, without explosion, was made by Starship prototype SN-15, thus it's quite probable that footage was of SN-15 flight test. Tagging Starbase as the gateway to Mars is quite relevant and impressive comment from SpaceX. At present, Starship is the only probable futuristic vehicle under development which can be used for getting to Mars. Other spacecraft of such potential are not available yet, except NASA's SLS system, which is very expensive. Thus, SpaceX's Starbase can be seen as the gateway for this interplanetary transport. As per preparations for the flight test, we know that SN-20 has already completed its standard static fire test. Now, as the report says, SpaceX is awaiting the Federal Aviation Administration to give their ruling with regard to whether SpaceX teams can proceed with an orbital flight. Mixed reviews from the public are coming in large numbers during consultations concerning Starship's environmental impact. Now we've got to wait and watch what happens to Starship. Our next update is based on the arrival of SpaceX's newest Crew Dragon capsule, Endurance, at the launch site prior to the Crew 3 launch. SpaceX is on track to launch their Crew 3 mission at 2:21 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time on the 31st of October, Sunday, after their scheduled date got delayed by a day. This Crew 3 mission is the third operational astronaut launch and second crew rotation by SpaceX and NASA. In the Flight Readiness Review (FRR) carried out on the 25th of October, it seems that all things are well for the launch, except a minor issue with Crew Dragon's toilet. Joel Montalbano, NASA's ISS program manager, stated, "We had a good review today." While the Dragon toilet issue was being taken into account by both SpaceX and NASA, SpaceX teams had rolled out their fresh Crew Dragon spacecraft Endurance to the launch site with just a few days left for Crew 3 launch. Raja Shari, one of the Crew 3 astronauts, tweeted, "Hashtag Endurance is in the hangar at NASA Kennedy. Hashtag Crew 3 will be headed there tomorrow for rollout to meet our ride and get ready for our Halloween launch to join at NASA underscore astronauts on the at space underscore station." As Boeing Starliner is yet to start its service, thus, SpaceX got another chance to have two Crew Dragons docked at the space station at the same time. With the arrival of Crew 3 astronauts in the station, Crew 2 astronauts will become free to come back to Earth. Both NASA and SpaceX have been working on Crew Dragon's toilet system, thus there's a slight upgrade in the toilet design. They're now studying that design for qualification. Neither NASA nor SpaceX feels that this qualification procedure can delay the Crew 3 mission, Thus, we can hope for on-time launch. Report says that the issue with Crew Dragon toilet was noticed for the first time during the Inspiration 4 mission, which sent 4 civilians to space. After the completion of the mission, when the Resilience Crew Dragon was checked out, this problem was revealed. Report says it was seen a tube which was connected to the toilet storage tank became loose and leaked. Bill Gerstenmaier, Vice President of Build and Flight Reliability at SpaceX, said this allowed urine to not go into the storage tank, but essentially to go into the fan system. But this problem didn't hinder the mission, as Gerstenmaier says, "We didn't really even notice it. The crew didn't notice it until we got back to Earth." Now SpaceX has resolved to renovate the toilet system of the Endurance capsule. According to some sources, SpaceX has planned to use welded structures for the refurbished toilet system to avoid leakage. But final approval from NASA is a must before the Dragon capsule can get to space. As per recent updates, similar issues may have cropped up in other Crew Dragon capsule Endeavour presently docked in the space station. Gerstenmaier stated, "After these issues were noticed in the Resilience, astronauts in the space station have checked the Endeavour, but nothing worrying has been found." He expects that the one-day duration of Crew 2 rather than 3-day duration of Inspiration 4 has put lesser effect on the Endeavour capsule. As we know, Crew 3 mission will debut a new Crew Dragon capsule named Endurance, which is the beginning of the introduction of several new Dragons as part of SpaceX's plan to double its fleet of reusable orbital spacecraft in less than a year. Following that plan, on the 24th of October, SpaceX teams rolled out the Endurance capsule to Kennedy Space Center Launch Complex 39A. Before rolling it out, engineers have carried out necessary works, and finally they also fueled up the capsule with monomethylhydrazine propellant and nitrogen tetroxide oxidizer. According to some reports, it's expected that after rollout, they'll join the Endurance capsule with the Falcon 9 upper stage, which is already attached to the flight-proven Falcon booster. Report also states that after completion of the mating process between Crew capsule and Falcon second stage, the Dragon and Falcon 9 launch vehicle will roll out to Pad 39A for an integrated static fire test. Then it's expected that a dry dress launch for astronauts may also be carried out with the Crew 3 astronauts Thomas Marshburn, Raja Shari, Kayla Barron, and Matthias Maurer. Now, at last, if the tests and rehearsals, and also the weather, go on in a normal manner, then the Crew 3 mission can be launched easily on the scheduled time and can also dock with the space station in time. As with other crew missions, Crew 3 astronauts will also stay for 6 months' time in the space station. Let's wrap up our space updates with Airbus Ventures' investment in iSpace. On the 25th of October, Airbus Ventures publicized that they've moved for an investment on a Tokyo-based company, iSpace. iSpace has become popular as they're preparing for sending their first lunar lander aboard SpaceX Falcon 9 in late 2022. Louis Pinault, one of the partners of Airbus Ventures, stated that they thought to invest in iSpace as it's an extraordinary team that has positioned the right technologies at the right time. They have every chance of being the first private company on the moon. iSpace was founded in 2010, and they're having good developing relations with other public and private space agencies. iSpace has plans to work on lunar minerals and energy resources to use it to help support life on Earth. Pinault further stated that Airbus Ventures is too interested in iSpace's idea to acquire data on lunar mineral and energy resources. Pinault stated that the moon has the opportunity to become the first space for off-world manufacturing, which would alleviate the stresses that manufacturing puts on our planet. As per recent updates, iSpace has raised nearly $200 million by the 25th of October. Takeshi Hakamada, CEO of iSpace, said, "It's an honor to receive this investment from a truly global organization like Airbus Ventures, which is another first direct investment from an international institutional investor for iSpace, along with Axiom Asia Private Capital. iSpace plans to launch their second lunar mission in 2023. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.